大家好，我是蔡律师啊，我们在新瑞明律师事务所。我们今天呢，这个视频的题目是美国名校大学生谈大学生活啊。和我在一起的呢是 Sabrina 啊，Sabrina 呢为我们新瑞明律所工作，另外呢她是美国麻省理工学院 MIT 的大学生啊。那么今天呢，我和 Sabrina 简单呢，我们讨论一下，说最近啊，根据她的亲身经验经历，讲到呢美国大学生活的一些方面。OK，Sabrina. So let's start. 那第一个问题呢，我希望简单讨论的是关于很多中国家长嘛啊，这个我们的观众也都有兴趣，想知道，比如说我要被名校录取要什么样的条件，名校学生一般呢有什么样的背景，或者说什么样的资质有利于被录取。
Yeah, so I would say that I see a wide variety of students. There's no one specific mold that MIT is looking for. I think that obviously you want to make sure that you're keeping up good grades, good test scores, but they don't have to be perfect. And what I would say is more important is following your interests. So a lot of students I know have one particular interest that they were really into in high school, whether that's robotics or even like a sport or an instrument or something, just to show that you're really self-motivated and you really have passion, even if it's not the same area that you're going to pursue in college, then colleges like to see that, just to see that you're able to motivate yourself and that you really have something that you're interested in and that you're able to work towards. So I would say pursuing activities outside of classes is just as important as your grades in school.
Great, thanks. 我们刚才讲到了关于申请学校啊，学术方面。那么关于生活方面呢，比如说我自己在过去在北大上大学的时候呢，我们那个时候很普遍都是六个人一间宿舍。那么在美国的宿舍呢，大家知道啊，不同的这个情况呢可以相差很多，对吧？本科生啊，怎样住宿的，这个可能也是很多学生和家长关心的问题。
Yeah, so for your first year on campus, all students are required to live in one of the campus dorms. And so you get to choose which dorm, and you can have either a single, double, triple, or quad, which is 1 to 4 students living in a room together. Usually freshmen will get doubles or above, since usually the singles will go to upperclassmen. Then after your first year, some students will choose to stay in the dorms, some will choose to move off campus on their own into apartment buildings, and some will move into fraternities, sororities, or independent living groups, which are kind of like social clubs that live together in a house off campus.
Okay, thanks. 衣食住行嘛啊，除了住呢，大家可能对日常啊吃饭这个是吧，学生怎样安排也比较关心。那么在家里嘛，靠父母啊，父母就给做好就行了。那么在外面上学的时候呢，那怎样解决说这吃饭问题，是在食堂里啊，还是怎样做，本科生啊，那么我们在这里讨论一下。
Yeah, so MIT has two types of dorms, dining dorms and non-dining dorms. If you live in a dining hall dorm, there will be a dining hall inside of your building that usually serves breakfast and dinner, and some of the ones also serve lunch. And so some students choose to eat there. And if you live in a non-dining dorm, there will be kitchens for your floor or your house, and you can choose to cook your meals there. MIT also has some restaurants in the student center and is close to Central and Kendall Square, which have their own restaurants, which students will go to for lunch or dinner with their friends.
Thanks.好，那么学生嘛，当然主要任务还是学习。我们前面讲了说啊，怎样住啊，然后这个吃饭啊，以及被录取。那么被录取以后呢，啊，说那我选择什么样的课程，什么样的专业啊，这个求学方面，在这方面在校园有什么样的经历，讨论一下。
Yeah, so the most popular major is probably computer science, followed by some of the engineering ones like mechanical engineering. But there's a lot of majors such as nuclear engineering that you might not have had a chance to be exposed to in high school that would be good to explore when you first get on campus. The first year, a lot of students take core classes, and that's kind of to give you an opportunity to explore and see what classes that really interest you before you have to declare a major at the end of your first year. So the major you apply with is not the major that you're necessarily stuck with. As for the classes themselves, they can be difficult, but I've found that professors and TAs, and as well as the other students, are all very supportive. I generally work on my problem sets with other students, and we can help each other. And there's also, at all hours of the day, there's office hours where you can go in to get help on your homework and help on understanding course concepts. So I found that it's a hard workload for sure, but definitely a very supportive environment.
Okay, thank you. 那么我们讲到了这些啊，有学业、生活、衣食住行。那么我们知道呢，波士顿是全美国来自世界各国的留学生最多的城市啊，大概也是中国留学生最多的城市啊。和所有的其他美国城市相比，波士顿有更多的学校啊，包括大学、中学。那么在那里读大学本科、读私立高中，以及读研究生，还有做访问学者、博士后的各种中国学者啊，也都很多。那我们的客户呢，也有很多是来自啊波士顿地区的。那我们在这里讨论一下，比如说中国留学生啊，在这个学业这方面的情况。
Yeah, so I have a couple friends who are international students, but sometimes it's actually pretty difficult to tell who's an international student because they tend to adjust pretty well into campus. And MIT also has students from all over and from all different backgrounds. So I would say that they generally adjust pretty well.MIT also has a separate office for international students, and they make sure to orient these students well, and there's always there as a resource if you have any questions about adjusting to American life. So I would say in general, the international students seem pretty happy, pretty well adjusted.
Okay, great. Thank you, Sabrina. 对，这个呢是我们关于留学方面的这样一个视频。如果想要了解更多的这个留学方面的信息呢，可以看我们 YouTube 频道的其他视频，我们的微信公众号叫美本美高留学指南。另外呢，我们在这个网站美国攻略上面的文章专栏上面有更多的信息。像前面介绍的呢，Sabrina 呢为我们律所啊新卫明律所来工作。另外呢，我们律所也有其他的 Native English Speakers， 还有其他的专业人士，有很多博士和硕士学位的专业人士，有很多人有美国留学和办理绿卡移民方面的亲身经验，我们已经有十几年的丰富经验，为数千名来自中国的学者专业人士取得了绿卡和各类签证的批准。那么很多人办移民也是为了这个子女的发展啊，这个留学，所以呢这也是相关的。所以呢我们经常也会有一些介绍留学方面的信息。那有更多的问题可以联系我们，谢谢。